Do you know how much pollution is in our air here in Tucson? Do you know the simple steps that you can do to limit our pollution? And do you know that you could get $100 for doing so? Well, here at the answer to some of those questions is Beth Grohman, who is with Pima County Department of Environmental Quality. Good morning and good to have you here, Beth. So we're not in Los Angeles, so I don't think a lot of us here in Pima County think about our air quality so much. So how is it here?
Well, I know we don't really think about it unless we can see it or smell it. And fortunately, that doesn't happen that often. But we've got really good air quality for a community our size. The majority of the days that we monitor air quality are the days are in good, in the good range. And there's a couple of days during the year where the air quality gets a little bit unhealthy for sensitive people. But all in all, we've got really good air quality.
And I heard recently that now in the ozone air pollution season that we're in that currently, I mean, I think a lot of people would say that we think about the ozone layer as a good thing and we want it in our atmosphere. So can you tell us about the ozone air pollution season and what that really means for us here?
Yeah, it is really confusing because the ozone layer is something that we need for human life on this planet. It protects us from solar radiation. But then down at nose level, at human level, there's also an air pollutant called ozone. And we call it ground level because it's created by the emissions that we put into the air, but it's also created under certain weather conditions. And we have those this time of the year, from April through about September, when the sun is high above us, we've got the pollutants that we put into the air react with strong solar radiation to form this pollutant called ground level ozone. And it's very damaging for some people's health.
So who would you say is most vulnerable when our air quality is poor?
Yeah, we know when air quality is poor because we have a great monitoring system set up. And the people that are most affected are people who are elderly, people who have lung disease, people who have heart disease, also children who are outside playing because, you know, they're running around, they're breathing in a lot more air per body weight than the rest of us. And then anybody that's working outside when air quality is poor. And so mostly people with lung disease and heart disease and elderly are the more severely affected.
Yeah, and again, it's not top of mind for a lot of us. So where does most of our air pollution come from in Pima County?
Well, most of it comes from the things that we do on a daily basis. You know, there are pollutants called particulate pollutants that get kicked up when there's a lot of wind and when the soil has been disturbed. There's that type of pollution, then that's that we can't really have a whole lot of control over. But anytime there's vacant land that's been disturbed from construction or from mining or even dirt roads and the winds come through, that's one source of air pollution. But the other source and the ground level ozone that we're talking about, it comes from a lot of different sources like our motor vehicles. It comes from gasoline fumes. It comes from industries. It comes from small equipment like gas-powered lawn and garden equipment. So lots of different sources, and they combine together in the presence of sunlight and stagnant air, high pressure system that we have over us sometimes, and build up to the point that it can become unhealthy.
And really, it's all on us as individuals to help keep that from happening and do our part. So what would you say the specific steps are that we can do on a regular basis?
Well, one of the big things, and we talk about that a lot, is driving less. And we have seen, since we've been staying home, we have seen an improvement in the air pollutants that we monitor for. So if we could try to keep those habits, you know, a few of those habits, maybe try to combine our trips to drive less, you know, organize and plan our trips a little bit better. Maybe as things start to open up again, we could try to share rides. And then the other thing is to try to refuel our vehicles later in the day. And then that way the sun is setting and it doesn't have time to react to the gasoline fumes that form that ground level ozone. But by driving less, that's a big part of it. and then by trying to use the gas-powered lawn and garden equipment less, and then refuel in the afternoons, and, you know, actions like that that can really help. And maybe using our bikes, maybe walking a little bit more, maybe taking the bus again when it becomes safe to do that. I've been doing that for over 20 years, and I've developed friendships on the bus, and I absolutely love it. And of course, I've saved lots of money and saved a lot of air pollution too.
Well, and you're also encouraging people with a $100 prize. So really quickly, how can our viewers get more information about winning this prize?
So yeah, we're trying to get people to take a pledge to drive less. They can go on our website, pima.gov/healthy air. And they can sign up to make a pledge to drive less, and we'll put them in a drawing for a $100 Visa gift card.
All right. Well, thank you so much, Beth. Really important information for all of us.
Thank you.
And you can take that Drive Less pledge and enter for a chance to win a $100 gift card. For all those details and to learn more about it, again, you can go to pima.gov/healthy air, or you can call them at 520-724-7400.